everyone, Decimus here. I've had a lot of questions about stealth and how it works in ESO and haven't really seen anyone else cover this before in their streams or videos, so I thought I'd make a video to hopefully explain how it works. Right, so let's begin with the basics. If you haven't taken or done any damage and aren't being aggroed by NPCs, you're able to sneak when not within anyone's detection radius. And most of you probably knew that already. Your detection radius is mostly determined by the gear you wear, and in some very rare cases by the gear your opponent wears. Oh, and also by race. Khajiit and Bosmer have smaller detection radius. You should be able to see these distances on the screen. So that's the basics. On to the more complicated stuff. First of all, if you deal direct damage to your opponent, you are still able to go back into sneak right away after damaging the target. Now if you deal damage with a damage over time effect to your opponent, you won't be able to restealth until 5 seconds after the last damaging tick, and any direct damage you deal to that target afterwards will also trigger this 5 second cooldown on restealthing. So that's dealing damage. How about when you take damage? Well, you're basically able to restealth at any point when outside the detection radius, if you haven't dealt any dot damage to the target, as explained before. However, any damage you take you out of sneak, meaning dots, for example, will continuously keep revealing you, as you can see on the screen. Also worth noting is that NPCs, including player pets, will prevent you from re-stealthing for 30 seconds after losing aggro, and while they're aggroed you can't stealth at all. So there are some ways to help you re-stealth better in PvP. One thing I like to do is hitting the crouch key and then dodge rolling while the eye is closing. This lets you avoid many instances of damage that would otherwise prevent you from sneaking. Another thing that helps is keeping those re-stealth cooldowns in mind and using cloak to get back into sneak. Also, being a stage 4 vampire can help, as it lowers the time it takes to go into sneak from 2 seconds to 1 second. Alright, that's pretty much all I can think of right now. If you have any questions or feedback, let me know in the comments, and thank you for watching. See you next time, bye.